folks, Little Chuck here. Hey, now I'm going to do something a little bit more unusual today. I'm going to do a guitar lesson. I'm usually doing this sort of clatter-banging harmonica one-man band stuff, but yeah, I thought I'd do this guitar lesson, and just recently I've discovered this TV show called The Detectorists and fell in love with the theme tune, and fell in love with it so much I kind of wanted to learn how to play it myself. Then I made a video and put it on Facebook of me playing it, and then that got some good traction. So I thought, well, what I'll do is I'll share the knowledge that I have gained in learning that song, because, you know, I know what it's like learning this stuff. You know, it's pretty tricky. So, yeah, I just thought I'd share the knowledge with you and hopefully get you on the road. So, so it's written by this guy, Johnny Flynn. I didn't know that until I did some Googling and discovered who he was, and really like his playing style and his singing style and everything. So, now, I believe this video to be pretty accurate. There's going to be a couple of exceptions, but I'll go through those later. But yeah, I think it's pretty much on par with what he's playing. So there's the original version, which is on the theme tune. But there's another version on YouTube, right? And I've got it up here now. It's called Johnny Flynn Performs Detectorists for the Line of Best Fit. That's the video that I've kind of learnt it from, all right? Because in that video, it's just him and the guitar. So you're able to really hear what he's doing, and then you get the bonus that at certain parts of the video, you get to see his fingers moving. Okay, so that's why I think it's pretty accurate. Now, obviously, on the recorded version, you know, I'm going to assume, but there's overdubs, and there's obviously there's other instrumentation as well, so they can sort of mess with the ear a bit. But, you know, I've always been an ear player. I started learning music, you know, before the internet or anything like that. So, you know, it's a case of moving a record needle over a record, you know, that kind of stuff. So rewinding cassette tapes. So, you know, I've sort of built up my ear training. So hopefully this is pretty much right, okay? I'm sure I'll find out in the comments box if it's not. So, all right, without further ado, let's get into the tune. So this version that I've taken it from, he's playing a 1934 National Trojan, so I thought I'd play it on my National. Now, okay, so it's only got a few basic parts to it, all right? Probably I worked out about four basic parts. Now, one of the main differences, and I'll go into this now, I'll just grab this, is that he has this picking style. It's a style I love, and I've admired many players who have it, where he's using a flat pick, but he's also using his fingers to get the other notes. Now, that's not my style. I don't do that. So, therefore, my picking style is going to be slightly different, and then maybe the picking itself will be slightly different, but it's... you know, it's going to be within QE, you know what I mean? But, so I'll go into that side of it in a bit more detail in a bit. Okay, now, the next thing is, and probably the most important thing, is what key is it in and what tuning is it in, okay? Now, this is my theory. I believe this to be right compared to that video, okay? So this is what I reckon he's in. He is in drop D, single drop D, with a capo on the second fret. Okay, now, so basically that is E down to a D, and then the rest of the string's the same. So that's D, A, D, G, B, D, capo on the second fret. Now, the reason I've come up with that, okay, is in the video, when he goes to a G chord, okay, which is the second chord in... Search through the lonely earth for me, right through the briar and bramble. He plays G chord here on the 5th fret. It's actually the 7th fret, but I've got a capo one, okay? So for the purpose of this video, I'm going to call it the 5th fret, okay? And he doesn't play a regular G chord. Obviously, he played that. Listen to it. It's terrible. Now, there is another way of achieving such thing, and that's in standard tuning. I'm now in standard, okay? Now, if you've ever played around with this half capo idea, you can put the capo over the bottom five strings and leave the top one open, okay? It's a great thing. It creates great drone. Now, when you play it, sounds great. Right, when it comes to the G, well, it sends through the lonely earth for me. Climb through the briar and bramble. That's me playing a standard G chord, right? Now, it works. It works. It's great. But it's not what it does on that video. Okay? It goes up here. So, and when you listen to it, that sounds very G. If you know what I mean. And when he plays it, it sounds a bit more droney. Yeah? So that's where I've got to that. Now, the other parts to this are the thing he does on the D. And occasionally. Alrighty. Now, that technically is called a D. I have no idea what it's technically called. Alright? It's a D with added fluffy bits on it. Alright, now, if you're into Queen, you know, that kind of idea. So basically, I'll bring this up a bit closer. He's just hammering on that E string. And then hitting back on the B string. And then added if he needs to. So I'm sure you'll come across that. Now, I mean, if this is your first guitar piece, this is going to be pretty challenging. But, you know, if you're used to finger picking and used to open strings and that kind of style, this will be easy peasy, you know. Yeah, I'm sure you'll have played with that a million times. Right. The second part he's got in there, he's got an A. All right. Which is a similar kind of vibe. All right. Which, again, If you look here, it's just standard A chord, adding that pinky there on the B string. Okay, now that technically is called an A. No idea. I'm just not one of those players. I'm an ear player, you know. So I've no idea what that is. I just call that an A run, you know. Okay, what else is he doing? He's got B minor chords. He's got a D chord, he's got A chords, and he's got this G. Now, when he plays the G, okay, bearing in mind we're in this weird tuning, we'll call this a weird G, alright? What I think he's doing there is he's just hitting the bass string on the 5th fret, 7th to the 7th fret, but got a capo on, and he's hitting with it, he's just basically hitting the B and the G string. Now, a guitarist told me years ago, he said, just because you've got 6 strings, you don't need to, you know, hit them all. So, I think that's all he's doing, is playing a partial chord. Yeah? Yeah? Now, so to put the parts together, he's going the D part. The D part at the beginning doesn't have that in it. That comes in about the second bar or something. Yeah? So that's the intro part. I'll go into a bit more detail. Now, then it's going to, will you search through the lonely earth for me? D. My weird G. Climb through the briar and bramble. I will be your treasure. A run. So that's the first part, just that. Now, the second part to this, it's quite a large part actually, it's just B minor to D. I felt the touch of the kings and the breath of the wind, call the call of the songbirds, they sang all the wrong words. A run again. Okay, and then my favourite bit, the okay, it's this, B minor, I'm waiting for you. A, D, weird G, B minor, A, D, minor A D G with G. B minor A D. Right. And that's pretty much it. Because the next bit just repeats from there. Now, if you've never played finger picking before, okay, this, you know, this is going to be a challenge. And so what I would do is go onto YouTube and check out the resources on YouTube about finger picking, okay? So there's millions of videos on there about Travis picking and thumb picks and all of that sort of stuff. So check them out first, okay? Now, obviously you can play this. It's a four chord song. That's the genius of it. And you can play it without that if you want. Will you search for me? Have that gem of the picking thing going on, does it, you know? So the essential part for me when I pick, okay, and again, I'm not Johnny Flynn, so I'm not going to pick exactly the same way as him, okay? And so that's my cop-out. So, but when I'm picking this, basically, essentially, I'm keeping a rhythm going. So I've got those two Ds. Two fingers? How many have I got? These other fingers are just noodling away at the bottom. So essentially, when I'm picking, I'm always trying to play the bass note, or the root note of the chord, and then follow any kind of melody stuff with the other fingers. Now, obviously, when I play the D, I've got to get that in while I'm going roughly. So the rhythm I'm playing, not exactly what he's playing, but, you know, we're in the ballpark. Yeah? At speed. Yeah, so likewise when I'm playing the A's.
Felt the touch of the king and the breath of the wind, called along by the songbirds. They sang all the wrong words.
Yeah? And then when I get to that G, as I said, a partial chord. So look, I hope that's been helpful to you. Feel free to add any comments and whatnot. Now, if you like what you see here, look, please check out my channel and subscribe. I do loads of kind of one-man band harmonica stuff, quirky stuff. So please check out that on YouTube. My albums are available, Blues in Full Swing and Utility Blues. They're on all the digital sites and via my website, backyardmusic.co.nz. Yeah, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, you name it. So, hey, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And Little Chuck, the one-man skiffle machine. See you again. Cheers.